Hi, so I am Marcelo. I am the lead developer on Boyfriend Dungeon, and I've been working on this for, I guess, in this project for 3.5 years. So I'm the lead programmer, so usually like we build systems, we make things work, we fix bugs, we get reports from our beta testers, and then we make improvements to the game. And also like there's all the other part of, implementing art and music and the dialogues, basically everything. We put everything together is what we do. I'm from Brazil. I went to school there and then I decided that I wanted to work with games. So I looked up and Canada was a very good opportunity. Like there were different ways that I could try this. So I moved to Canada and started in another games company and ended up finding Kitfox, which is where I work now for a while. And I love it. In Brazil, because of the environment that I was and the work environment, I felt like I had two lives, basically. I felt like because I wasn't out, I had to be this person at work and someone else in my private life. And when I moved to Canada, and especially after being at Kitfox, I felt like that wasn't necessary anymore and that I could just be one person, myself, everywhere, all the time. So it is freeing, it is liberating. I don't have to worry about this anymore. I can even, invite my boyfriend to work parties, which is great. It feels great. It feels liberating. It's pretty interesting because Boyfriend Dungeon is not explicitly queer. It's like you can be whoever you want and you can date whoever you want. So you can be completely straight if you want. It just allows you to be who you are. And doesn't force anything on you. So I feel like that's more freeing in a way. I hope people, when they play it, they do whatever they feel like doing. So like if they find someone interesting, even if it's not their main preference or whatever, like they can just go and date them. I just hope people feel like they can be whoever they want. Hopefully has an impact and hopefully people will be seen when they play this game. And now here's some clips from other queer people that made Boyfriend Dungeon possible.
I am Marion Toro and I voice Olivia the barista at Kick's Cafe.
So my contribution to Boyfriend Dungeon was doing some sensitivity consulting for the non-binary characters in the game. So there are two canonically non-binary characters and basically like sort of just looked over them, their dialogue and other aspects of their character and their story, their narrative arcs.
My name is Tiago Alves and I am a Brazilian Portuguese translator at the Boyfriend Dungeon.
To me, pride is about freedom, self-exploration, and being unafraid of showing who or what you are. It's about reflecting the best image of yourself and having people around you that both appreciate that and encourage it as well.
I made a game called Dominique Pamplemousse. I started working on it about 10 years ago now and released it in 2013. At the time I was making it, I was not even like out as non-binary. So this was kind of like, so Dominique Pamplemousse became my way of coming out publicly and being like, okay, here is a game with a non-binary character as the protagonist. And by the way, this is me. Great.
I'm pansexual. I first heard the term from the singer Janelle Monáe. And when she described it, I was like, oh, that's me. That makes sense. Oh, because I was like, wait, I'm not bi because, I don't care about your gender. I don't care about gender. So I'm like, where do I fit? I felt very alone and unseen. Best way to say that. So when you have someone on that level with that type of platform speaking up about it, it just was like, oh my gosh, hey, I see me, like, that's me. So yeah.
You cannot detach of what you are. You kind of, even if you're not very conscious of it, you kind of bring yourself into the project. And then as a queer person, it is something that also translates into my words.
In terms of queerness in games, I know representation is huge, and that's what I was going to say originally, but I'm going to say exploration. It's cool if we get like a LGBTQ character in a game, but how much do we know about them? How much are they actually in the game? How much of their character do we get to see about them? How much do we actually go into their world and explore what they're dealing with, you know?
There are more examples, more and more, of good characters that aren't just centered on their sexuality or that are casually represented, like, you know, like, because in the end, like, we're just people, you know, like, I have bills to pay, I have laundry to do. I just, you know, I just want to be represented the way that I am. I hope that in the future, queer games are just something that exists. I hope that it's not controversial or anything that is more special than any other type of game.
Honestly, what I hope for is just to be more accessible and then to be treated as a, you know, just a regular and normal part of the character development.
When you see it, it's no different than the wind blowing. It's so natural. So I would just like to see, you know, if you happen to see that type of relationship, that it's not like a, oh, let me stop and think about that. No, honey, there's nothing to stop and think about. All you have to do is, if you appreciate it, cool. If you don't, move along.
If you like playing queer games, and if you think you want to make queer games someday, then yeah, you should totally go for it. It's a lot of fun, and it's become a lot easier to learn.
You're awesome. And find your group. Find people, or find an environment where you will feel comfortable, and so that you can be creative and express yourself. Because the world needs it.
We are being heard. They, you know, people who are creating video games, indie developers, they want to see us, and not just the indie space. Again, like the AAA games, like, these doors are opening up. Like, let's walk through them. And, you know, for the moments where we felt like our voices weren't being heard, oh, darling, trust and believe me, get on your microphone. They want to hear us.
It's very important that no one feels blocked or feel that because of their identity or how they present themselves, that they don't feel blocked out of the video game industry. So if you want to go, and I say especially for translators, just go for it. Study, learn new languages, learn new tools. Very, very important to, you know, like, to be prepared for what the industry is requiring.
Creators, video game developers, please continue to create stories that are showing all types of relationships, especially that of queerness.
Seeing more queer games means that more queer people will be able to see games and be like, oh, maybe I can do that too.
Thanks for watching. Happy Pride.
That's amazing.
Good to see him.
Wow. Yes.